It's girl Jackie, and I'm finally back after like a year and a half of not filming. I'm not gonna bore you with the details of why. That's not why you're here. So I'm gonna put all of that down in the information box and you can read it if you want. I don't even know how to do video anymore. It's been so long, oh my God. So I kind of was going back and forth on what I wanted my first video back to be. And I asked you guys on Instagram, which by the way, I'm gonna link to that down below if you wanna keep up with what's going on with me. And you guys wanted to see a Storybook Cosmetics collection video. So that is what I have for you guys today. Storybook Cosmetics is just a small indie makeup brand that I love so much. This, by the way, is not a sponsored video. They are not paying me to do this. If you'd like to sponsor me, Storybook Cosmetics, are you listening? I would be more than happy to work with you because I love Storybook Cosmetics. But I'm doing this video because one, I really like the products. Two, you guys really wanted to see this video. And three, I really like supporting small business. I feel like we spend so much time promoting these huge brands, really don't need the promotion. Meanwhile, there are indie brands who are doing really fantastic things in the world of makeup. And my favorite by far is Storybook. And you're gonna see that because I've got a ton of really great products to show you guys. I apologize for the background. I basically just kind of shoved myself into the only corner of the house that doesn't have my three-year-old stuff everywhere. Like literally, if you look around the rest of this room, first of all, this is her bed. All of her ballet stuff is just everywhere. There's just like tutus and glitter and ballet slippers and all kinds of stuff. So I'm just kind of wedged in this corner. I'm gonna start looking for another place in the house to film, but I really wanted to get this video done. Also, I'm not sure what the lighting is gonna be like, but I'm gonna start, you know, working on adjusting all those things. Let me know in the comments down below what you guys think about the lighting and all that stuff, or if there's anything that would make this video more enjoyable for you, because I make these videos for you. And also for me, because I enjoy it. So anyways, there is one little tidbit you guys need to know before I get into this video, and it is very, very important. And that is that this is all my natural hair. Yes, girl, yes, yes, bitch. My hair is back. I went to put in my extensions earlier, which I've been doing ever since I had my daughter and all my hair fell out, and my hair is longer than my extensions. Finally. So let me know in the comments down below if you guys want to see a hair journey video as to how I got my hair to grow back. A lot of you guys will remember in my previous videos, after I had my daughter, my hair got really short and I was really self-conscious and I was wearing extensions, but this is my normal natural hair. It's back. Anyway, before I get super sidetracked, here is my Storybook Cosmetics collection. So since this is a collection video, I'm not gonna do full-on reviews of each of these products. I'm just gonna tell you about them, tell you how much I like them, how much they are, where you can get them, and that sort of thing. If you guys see anything in this collection that you want a full-on review or full-on swatches of, let me know again in the comments down below. But I am gonna start out with the very first product that Storybook Cosmetics ever put out, and that is the Harry Potter Wizard Wand Makeup Brushes. They come in this cute little pouch, which I'm not going to hold up to the camera too close because my daughter tried to brush the cat with it and now it's covered in cat hair. This is the life of a toddler mom, I guess. But this was their first product that they ever launched, and these are gonna look a little bit different than the ones that you'll see on their website right now, which by the way, I'm gonna link to all these products again in the comments down below, as well as the Storybook Cosmetics site. These look different than the ones they're selling now because this was the first iteration of them. So these are the brushes. There's some blending brushes. Oh, you can see that this one is dirty because I use this to do my, my eye makeup today. But this is what the brushes look like. This is what, okay, I gotta figure out how to do this, guys. This is what the handles look like. They are so beautiful. And they are made of pewter. They are very strong, very sturdy. I've had these since December 2016. I think I got them for Christmas 2016. And if you can see, they're all pretty much still intact despite the fact that I've been using and washing these regularly. These were about $55 for the set. Totally worth it, in my opinion. I tend to be one that I don't like to spend a lot of money on brushes. I feel like I can get something from Real Techniques or something that's just as effective and not super pricey, but these brushes I think were totally worth it. Because one problem I have with brushes all the time is that the top part comes off of the handle after I use and wash them a lot, and these are still completely intact, and I haven't had to buy eye makeup brushes since I got these in 2016 and it's 2018 now, so I think that's a pretty good deal. And they just look really cute on your makeup table too, which you guys know aesthetic is really important to me. So I think this is money well spent. And you are gonna see a lot more of those when I start doing tutorials again, because I use them pretty much every day. So the next thing is the Storybook Cosmetics Wizardry and Witchcraft palette, which I was super excited and I couldn't wait to get my hands on this one. These colors, you guys are gonna see, I clearly have a few favorites, but let me show you all of the colors in this. So this is what the palette looks like. Their eyeshadow formulas are fantastic. They are velvety, they're very richly pigmented, they stay all day, they don't crease. Honestly, I was shocked because this, I think, was just their second product, and when I got it, I was really not expecting a whole lot, just because a lot of novelty items and things that you get that are, you know, based on a movie or based on some kind of TV show or whatever, tend to not be really high quality. They tend to just be more for the novelty of having the item. These eyeshadows are so good, which you guys can totally tell, because if you can see, I've hit pan on Salem and Bewitched because I just use these so much. Let me know if you guys want to see a full review of this palette, because it's really incredible. I'm also going to be relaunching my blog soon, so if you guys don't want to see a video, maybe you want to see a blog post where I post swatches of these and maybe a couple of the looks that I've done, which there have been many. I've done a lot. So the next thing I have, oh, by the way, that palette retails for $55. A lot of their things retail for $55. So again, I think it's well worth it. I've been using it for like a year and a half. The next thing I have from Storybook is the Charlie and the Chocolate Factory palette, which is just incredibly colorful and gorgeous. Again, these high shadows are extremely high quality. You're gonna see that these are not as used as the Wizardry and Witchcraft palette. I tend to kind of stick to neutrals for my day-to-day life, but this, I actually just busted this out for a photo shoot. I just had my first photo shoot recently. It was a glitter themed photo shoot. I'm sure you guys are not surprised at all by that. Maybe I'll throw some pictures in here and link to them or something so you guys can see. But I used this palette for that and it translated so beautifully on camera and it's just so gorgeous, and I'm definitely gonna start using this a lot more. This one also is $55 and again, totally worth it, especially if you like really bright colors. This next one is my favorite. I'm sure it will be a surprise to no one. It is the Storybook Cosmetics Burn Book Palette. Yes, I love Mean Girls. It is one of my favorite movies of all time, and I got this for an anniversary gift last, I think it was December. So this looks more than lightly used, which I tried to clean it up, but honestly, like, does it even really matter? I really hate when people do collection videos and reviews and it looks like they haven't even used the product. Like, all they did is swatch it and they're sitting here trying to tell me why I should buy the product. I use this a lot and you can see I'm totally hitting pan on this. I use a lot of these colors. Oh my God, I love this color so much, you guys. This is one of my favorites too. This looks really amazing with a smoky eye. This one I use almost daily. I love this color so much for a lid color. But this palette is just fantastic. I love the packaging. All of their packaging is amazing. I mean, look at how much time and effort they put into these palettes. Like, they're really trying to stay true to the brand that they're trying to represent. They're really trying to stay true to the theme of the product. It's just phenomenal for an indie company. It's unbelievable. Again, this is $55, which I know $55 sounds like a lot of money, but it's really not when you think about how much these palettes are these days. They're all $50 to $60. And I feel like this quality is either on par with the other more popular brands, or it may even surpass the quality of other brands I've used. I personally like their quality more than like Urban Decay or Too Faced, and I use those brands all the time. But Storybook Cosmetics, whatever formula they're using works. It's amazing. The next thing is the only lip product of theirs I own. They've launched lip products recently, and this one was a Christmas gift, and this is the Wizardry and Witchcraft Liquid Lipstick Collector's Edition. I can't read or speak all of a sudden, apparently. But look at how gorgeous these are. They are incredible. Maybe I'll swatch these for you guys on my hand. These I really love. I don't use them every day just because these are colors that I tend to not use every day. Like this green one, for example, is something that I'm probably gonna use for, I was Tafiti for Halloween, and I'm gonna continue doing that costume as like a cosplay. So I'm definitely gonna use this color for that. Look at how gorgeous this is, oh my God. Or maybe like a Christmas photo shoot or something. These are so richly pigmented. They're like a cream, they're not matte, they're not high gloss, but they're very moisturizing, which I really appreciate because my lips tend to be a little bit sensitive. So I have to be very careful about the lip products I put on. Oh, by the way, this green color is called Potions, which I just love the name. This one is called Salem. It's like a neutral brown. And I've probably used this one the most out of the palette. And I like this one because it's a very rich brown. There you go. Those actually look really good together. Hmm. Interesting. But this one is just so gorgeous. And I love to put this one. Sometimes I will line my lips with NYX lip liner in mahogany, and then I'll put MAC lipstick in taupe, and then I'll put this over and it looks phenomenal. This one I've also used pretty often. It's called Sorcerer, and it's just a really gorgeous red color. And I put this over red lipstick all the time, and it just pops so well. And it pops really well on camera, which I really love. And honestly, it's pigmented enough that you could put it on by itself. For me, because it's a very cool red and I have gold undertones, I tend to put like a brown-based red on first, and then I'll put this on over just to give it like a little more pop. But it's so long-lasting, you guys. I have this issue where when I wear red lips, they kind of feather a little bit and it just looks awful, and that never happens with this at all. This one I've only used like once, and it was to take pictures, and this one is called Merlin, but wow. I mean, really, okay? I mean, come on. Oh, it's so pretty. I cannot wait to come up with some kind of costume or cosplay or something for this, but wow, it's just like, here we go. It's this really gorgeous tone blue. There we go. I really like these colors because they're very jewel tones. And if you can see, they're really bright. They're very vibrant. The formula is great. It's non-drying. This set was $55 and honestly, again, completely worth the money. And now I have to figure out how not to get all this on my pants. Okay, see, Kirkland wipes. These are incredible and I never leave home without these because otherwise I swatch things and I get them all over my clothes and then I ruin my new clothes, so. Okay, there we go, all clean. So that was my first video back. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I was trying to do something kind of short and sweet just to get myself warmed up. It's kind of hard if you do YouTube and you take a really long hiatus, you can probably relate. It's really hard to get back into things. And so I wanted to do something kind of like low key just to get myself used to filming again and help me like figure out my filming situation. I'm definitely going to wait to do tutorials until I get my lighting set up correctly, because otherwise you guys aren't going to be able to see the colors on my face. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I am linking to everything down below. If there's anything I missed, any questions you guys have about these products that I didn't cover, I was trying to keep it short and sweet. So if you want more detailed information, let me know your questions in the comments down below, or ask me to either make another video about any of these specific products, or I can make a blog about it when my blog relaunches, which is very soon. You're also going to notice, Glitter Army, that my Instagram name is different. There's a reason for that. I'm not gonna tell you what it is right away, but just make sure you follow this one. This is where I'm gonna update all of my makeup related things and adventures and misadventures and what I'm working on currently and that sort of thing. There are big things coming up that I've been working on, I just haven't been filming, but you guys are going to know very, very soon. So I'm so glad to be back. I've missed you guys so much. Thank you so much for stopping by to hang out with me. Thank you so much for sticking by me, for checking in on me. You guys are always asking me when I'm coming back, how I'm doing, and I appreciate it so much. You guys have been with me since 2008 and I appreciate it and I will always appreciate it. And I love you so much, Glitter Army. Those of you who are new to my channel, don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you can be notified when I upload new videos. And welcome, welcome to the Glitter Army. We have a lot of fun here. And if you are new, let me know in the comments so that I can say hi. I really like to get to know my viewers. I know a lot of you on a first name basis. After all these years, I'm friends with a lot of you guys on social media and I feel like I'm talking to family. So if you are new, please feel free to say hi. I love meeting the people who watch my videos. So anyways, that is it for me. I might film another video after this one so I have something that I can post next week as well. We'll see. But anyways, thank you guys so much for everything. I love you and I will see you soon. Bye.